Hello friends, welcome to Reach Goals. Today there is an interesting interview question, that is how a great API should be, and I'm going to talk about its best practices. The first one is API should be easy to learn, easy to use. What does it mean is there are hundreds and thousands of API, and if you're not able to learn that and if you're not able to utilize it, it's going to be useless, right? So you have to write an API in such a way it can be easily learned and it can be easily used. Let me give an example. For example, if you want to create an account, the API should be named like, you know, create account. Or if you want to have an API like delete account, it has to be delete account. It should not have any fancy terms or names, which is not easily understood by any of the users, right? And the second one is API should be hard to misuse. So let's say you define an API and it is very clear it has to be exposed to the third party vendors or it be within your company, right? So you should write in such a way it should not be misused. For example, if you write an API to delete an account, it should be specific to an user where you are going to delete it. Let's say delete account, you have to give the user ID. Let's say you given a you expose an API in such a way you given delete account, and if you don't provide any ID or anything as a parameter to delete, there is a possibility that API can be misused and all the accounts can be deleted. So you have to be very careful when you define those kind of an APIs, right? So the next one is API should fail fast. So this is one of the very interesting thing. Let's say you have a method which has hundreds of lines. Now you came to know that at the 95th line or 96th line, the API fails or there is a issue in your code, right? So there is no reason for going up to 95 lines and getting it fail, right? So what actually it has to be done is it has to be fail as early as possible. So failing at the compile time is much better rather than you know, going to fail at the runtime. So you have to be very clear the API should fail fast to make sure that API is perfectly utilized in all the ways, right? The next one is API should have good names. Names should be self-explanatory, right? So this is very common thing and it's a very easy to learn thing, right? API should have a good names. So for example, you are writing an API to send an email or send a message. It should have something like send message, or if you're checking the status of an account, it should have something like check status, right? So if it is not able to easily understood, then it's not going to be helpful for any others to make use of it, right? So that is what I meant. API should have good names. Name should be self-explanatory. And the other one is API should be split into modules. Let's say you have an application and you have n number of functionalities, and if you are not splitting up the APIs into the modules, it is very hard to refactor when there is a need. So that is why it's like a divide and conquer. You have an API, you split into modules so that it can be easily utilized by somebody else, right? So this is another interesting line, like, you know, when in doubt, you have to leave it, right? So if you are in a doubt and if you're adding some functionalities and it is very difficult to remove later, right? So let's say if you remove it, it is going to impact all the users who are already using those APIs. So that is why I'm saying that when in doubt, just leave it. You can add, but you cannot, but it is difficult to remove it later, right? So the next one is maximize your information hiding. Don't let information leak in logs or exception. Sometimes you would have seen an API, somebody writing like, you know, there is an exception happening in the due to database, and they would say the database name or the field name in the exception message. So it's easy for the hackers to understand what is your database and what kind of field you're using it, right? So you should not let API to leak the information. Similarly, if you are writing some logs, you should make sure that you are not writing user information or user email into the logs. So it's like a PII compliance, right? So that should not be used like that. That's what I meant. Maximize information hiding. Don't let information leaks in the logs and exceptions. So the other point is minimize coupling between the APIs. So if you have a lot of APIs and you always would have seen that multiple APIs are interacting with each other, right? So if you have too much of couplings, like if you want to refactor your API, it is very difficult. That's why you had to minimize the coupling between the APIs so that it can be used very efficiently. The next one is document as much as possible for the users to understand. So whenever you write an API, it should be self-explanatory, right? So if somebody reads the API, they should be able to understand what the API is for, how it is meant, and how it can be utilized. So you have to document in such a way anybody who don't understand the software applications has to understand the API and make utilizing the APIs, etc., right? The next one I have is keep performance in mind while designing the API, right? So this is a very important thing, right? Let's say you write an API and you have to make sure the API is perfectly tested to meet the latency, to see whether API is performing well, utilizing the memory to best of its ability, etc. Right? If you're not looking into the performance, and then the API is really going to become useless and nobody is going to use it, right? So keep in mind, whenever you write an API, the performance is handled and you are testing the performance as well to when you are publishing to some other third party or to the external vendors, right? That's it I have. Thanks for watching. If you have any comments, you can put in the comment section and make sure you are subscribing to get some more information about these videos. Thank you.